We're going to have to say that we have to classify the different types, different states of matter. Now we're going to say that under appropriate conditions of temperature and pressure, matter can exist in three different states. We know what these are. They're solids, liquids, and gases. And here on the bottom, I basically give us three illustrations to help us see the different types of matter, the different states of matter. So we're going to say in the first blank, we're going to say these have a fixed shape and volume, meaning that if I put them in a container, they hold on to their properties, their physical features. So if we take a look at this first container, we can see that we have some type of solid in there, maybe a lump of clay, lump of dirt. That's going to be our solid. Solids don't take on the shape of the container or fill up the volume. For the next one, we say that these guys take up the shape and volume of the container. Now, some of you might say this is a liquid, but that's not always true. The better answer is our gases. Gases will take up the shape and volume of the container. If we take a look at this third image right here, you can see that inside the container looks a little bit pink. That pink color is basically gas molecules spreading themselves out as far as possible to take up every single inch inside of that container. We're going to say that when gases do this, they're behaving ideally. We won't get to see this yet. We'll see this later on in the semester when we're focusing predominantly on gases. But just remember, this is a normal behavior of gases. If you give them any amount of room, they're going to take all of that room up. So that leaves us this last one. We're going to say that liquids will conform to the shape of the container, but not necessarily the volume. They don't always take up the volume. So for example, we take a look at this picture. We can see that we have a red liquid at the bottom of the container, but there's not enough liquid to take up the entire volume of the container. We can say that we might have 10 milliliters of the liquid, but the container itself can hold up to about 30 milliliters. As a result, we don't have enough liquid to take up the entire volume. So, just remember, chemistry is just the study of matter. Matter has three different states. Each one have certain properties that they hold true to themselves. And remember, we're going to talk more later on about physical and chemical changes that matter can undergo. Understand these basic principles so that we can branch away from them to more complex and more chemical-based equations and ideas and concepts.